it's a small island. Curacao. We all come back.
Jova.
Malaga. Everybody knows each other.
Javier! Bing, bing, bing!
That's why I come back. I always say thank you.
We are a tiny island population with 150,000 people, but baseball-wise, we have percentage more big leaguers than all.
What a play by Edwardson Simmons! Another three-run home run for Didi Gregorius!
From 82 till now, we have signed about 200 guys in the professional baseball.
Started on the island between the Venezuelans and the Dominicans. They came to sell fruits, to do business. They brought their gloves and bats and stuff. Soccer was the main sport.
Well, first of all, I was a soccer player because my dad was like a captain of the national soccer team.
Soccer was the sport that we played in school. We didn't play no baseball in school like they play in the States.
I didn't start playing baseball until I was 9. They were gonna found a new baseball team on our soccer field. And there was some flyers going around to attract kids to come try out. I was very good at soccer, but was kicked around a lot. So I wanted to get away from that. When I turned 16, that's when I focused just on baseball, because that's when I started getting a lot of attention from major league teams. And I was hitting some bombs. They were like, wow, this guy is like Batman from the Flintstones. You know, that's how it started. Most people don't know my first name. Everybody calls me Bam Bam.
Before Anzio, the scouts didn't come very often over here.
We had big players, good players, but never the scouts didn't used to come here.
Anzio, that is one of a kind. He was always strong, had a good power, he could hit for average. That is unique.
And all of a sudden, there was people at my parents' house asking to sign me. Fred Ferrara, who was the international guy for the Yankees at the time, he says, hey, I want to sign you right now. I want to sign you right now. My dad is like, no, we didn't come to sign. So we call my mom. My mom is like, over my dad's body. Nobody's ever made it.
His father at first doubted a little bit. He wanted his son to study. We kind of convinced him, gave him a chance.
I told my dad, this may be the only opportunity I get to be a professional. You know, I want to do it. I'll give 100% and I'll make it. He got back, went to school, then told the principal, I'm out of here. He's like, what are you doing? You're so stupid. Nobody's ever made it. 3.5 years later, I was playing in New York for the Yankees. Got called up August 23rd of 1989. I just turned 22. The day arrived, you know, that the barrier was broken, the door was knocked down for this country for people to start playing in the big leagues.
I think I was more nervous than Hansley was. His first base hit was a hit to center field, and I was crazy.
And there it is, his first major league base hit, Hensley Bam Bam Mullins.
It's unbelievable.
So they'll be celebrating in the Caribbean tonight in Curacao.
I had to swipe the tears of my cheeks.
Nobody ever thought it was even possible. But after so many years of trying and hoping and this, Hensley made it.
Afterwards, when Hensley became our first big leaguer, baseball became more popular over the island because he broke a barrier. Now, who will be the next one?
One ball, one strike. That may be gone. Home run number one. Welcome to the big leagues, Andrew Jones.
Back then, every Wednesday, they were putting Braves game on TV.
I was just watching it on TV with my grandfather, and after I started playing, that's when I look up really on Andrew Jones.
Andrew in the World Series of 1996, the popularity of baseball became widened by the popularity of Andrew.
After that, when Jones made the major league, then the baseball grew up.
And so then the kids wants to be like Andrew when when they had interview with them at the World Series, they asked all the players, who's your hero?
The Little League World Series.
Nós vamos fazer um exame para o par. Meu jogador favorito é Andrew Jones.
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 You're on TV every day, you know, of course they're going to say, you know, Andrew Jones is their my favorite player.
When our team makes it to the final game in the World Series, everybody is sitting behind the TV watching the game. All the bars, all the restaurants, all the house, I mean, it's great.
So now I'm seeing Jonathan and Profar and some of these other kids on the field, the guys that we give clinics to. I'm like, yeah, you know, let's go do this. And then ultimately they won the big prize, they were world champions, and that was a really, really proud moment.
Our first time we became world champions, everybody wants to see you, wants to meet with you, wants to have an autograph. It's like crazy.
So this is pretty much my home. This is where everything started. This is where 16 years ago I started playing baseball. Here. So I took this mini shortcut to go to the field every time. I had one goal since I was 8 years old. And I worked hard and I reached my goal when I was 20 years old in 2017.
A ball on strike.
As you see, you can see some rocks on the field. You don't see this in the United States. Taking a ground ball on this field, you know what kind of movement the ball's gonna do. It's gonna bounce, hit you in the face, hit you on the body, go over your head.
We are known for good infielders.
On the ground, Ozzie dives, great play!
Grabbed there by Simmons, gets to his feet and fires. Oh, what a play by Simmons!
I feel like Curacao, everybody have their swag of know how they can catch the ball. We catch ground balls on bad fields, and we learn and catch balls on bad field. And you know, when we get on these good fields that are smooth and you don't get much bad hop, that make it easy for them.
Balls hit me in the forehead, in the eye, in the mouth, cut my lip, but I never gave up because I knew that if I do it here, it's gonna be way easier for myself, and I had good success with it, so I'm gonna keep doing it. The people that used to run this field, they got older and they can't afford it anymore, so I'm looking forward to get out of my name and do it for them. I want to just restore the whole outside, make it a nice parking lot, put brand new fences, brand new dugouts, the backstop, just maintain it clean for the kids.
Que quando muito bom, não é bom três um time, pro ato, ainda tu rendo uma segunda.
Não,
vamos mandar. Tu rendo uma segunda, ter um time.
Ter um time.
Sim, não.
That was my obligation. And my obligation was give back to the community you grew up from. It's 30 years now of doing these clinics. Every big leaguer participates. All of our guys are proud of where they're from.
And that's why baseball is so important. Because you see all the young guys on the field, and they stand next to Andrelton Simmons that they see on TV playing. Before, you couldn't imagine that. They stand next to Kenley Jansen and then Ozzie Albies.
There are so many major leaguers from Curacao playing right now. I think it's very beautiful to see how they give back. That gives them even more hope to achieve their dreams.